It's Cooking with John.
50th show celebration! Hello everyone and welcome to the 50th Cooking with John show. Can you believe it? I really can't. I never thought it would go this far. There's going to be lots of different things going on in the show today. Lots of special surprises and segments and things like that. I will have a quick recipe to save some time, so I don't want to take up a lot of time, but I will show you a couple of cool techniques and stuff in the recipe. First, let's do a little bit of history on the show. The very first show was done in the house I lived in for 20 years, and it was a total joke.
First show was the crackers with peanut butter and chocolate pudding. That's just so ridiculous and silly.
Well, in that house was actually haunted. Suddenly, we were split in the house. One of the guys died, and we couldn't maintain the rent anymore ourselves. So I had to just fly with whatever I could, and I lost almost everything I owned.
Anyway, I moved in with a friend that I went to school with, and that's where I did the second show, was the onion burgers on the grill. And that was more serious, because those were seriously good. So, but then I moved out of that house, and I moved in with Kelly and Tony.
And that's the one where I'm doing in the great big room behind me. Those shows were done at Kelly and Tony's house. So I was living there for a while. I was still looking for a permanent place.
And now I finally got a permanent place, and this is where I've done the majority of my shows now.
So, anyway, there's a little bit of history. Let's look at some highlights of some previous shows. Let's just roll it.
Hey, everybody. It's Cooking with John.
Chicken bones. Oh, boy.
Okay, this time we're going to do peanut butter and horseradish, some hot sauce, and some garlic. Don't want tough noodles. Don't want to break nobody's teeth. That's old tooth-breaking joke. If you're working on a job site where, you know, you don't have a microwave oven, you can always start your car and put your lunchbox on your engine for 20 minutes.
How much does pirate corn cost? You give up? A buccaneer! A buccaneer, get it?
We're gonna make one of my favorite breakfasts. Eggs and corn.
This is not ordinary imitation crab meat. This artificial imitation crab meat. Oh!
Smells like fish. It has to be Himalayan pink salt. Sounds like it's got sinus problems. I never ate this stuff before. I never tried this before. I'm cutting the cheese. So first we start by peeling the potato.
You will need a banana and some pickles.
Oops, all done. Cheese all melty and gooey. What, somebody say, get no store price?
You scurvy landlubbers.
It's two thumbs up for me.
Okay, that was pretty fun. Let's go to a commercial, and we'll be right back with the recipe.
And now Milo for Star Muffler.
Star Muffler, Star Muffler, Star Muffler. Star Muffler, we want you to be quiet, quiet in the car. You're not far from a star, no matter where you are. Maybe you need new springs and shock absorbers too. We'll check your brakes and line your wheels. Your car will run like new. Star Muffler, we want you to save money, no matter who you are. We want you to be quiet and safer in your car. Star Muffler, Star Muffler, Star Muffler.
Now it's time for the John Show. So come on, door, everybody. Sit down, shut up, and watch.
Okay, for today's recipe, yesterday was Easter, and so I'm a day late. I'm going to make some deviled eggs today. I've boiled up 4 eggs to make deviled eggs, but now I have 5 eggs, okay, and one of them is raw. So I'm going to show you something here. There's a way to tell the difference between a raw egg and a boiled egg without cracking it, and we usually grab the egg and, oh, look at that. That's it right there. That's the raw egg. I'll show you why. This one, look at it spin. Well, I better get this out of the way before it breaks. Look how it spins. This one too. I'll make this one stand up. Look at it. Look at that. See it? And this one's also hard boiled. So on the first one, I got the one. See, now this one does not want to spin because it's viscous and it's goopy inside, and when you try to spin it, it doesn't drag along with the rest of it. A nice solid interior will drag along, will spin real well. Okay, so enough of that. I'm gonna put this back in the fridge. Now I'm gonna show you an easy way to crack eggs, to crack the hard-boiled egg. Now I've boiled these, and I've put them in ice cold water to shock them down. What that does is, now the shell itself remains pretty much solid, doesn't move much, but the interior, when it cools down, it shrinks and it pulls away from the shell, and that makes it so much easier to get the shell off. Now here's how I do it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to crack the egg down and then roll it like that. So watch this. Now that, oops, let's try another one. That one got away. Crack and roll. Now, okay, what that did was it kind of divided the shell into two pieces. Look at that, one piece and the other piece. Look at that. Now, it's also helpful if you peel them in water. I got a little bit of water in here. And if you want to, after you've cracked and rolled the egg, then you kind of dip it in the water, and that kind of helps to get the shell away from the egg. So it peels up real easy, just like that. So, okay, I'm going to finish peeling these eggs, and then we'll get back with the next step. Okay, we've got our eggs peeled, and the one that fell on the floor, it actually, the white actually broke in half, so that was easy. Now, water's your friend when you're prepping eggs, so dip your knife into some water so it'll slide through the egg nicely. Now, this time we're going to cut the egg sideways instead of top to bottom like the first one broke. So, get the yolk off into there, get the knife wet again, and that helps it slide through the egg. All right. Now, we eject the yolks. So, okay, we got yolks, we got the whites. So, okay, now we got to work on the filling. Now, there's lots of variations, man. You could put bacon in these things. Now, I like to put mustard, a little mustard in there. Actually, I'd like to make a couple of these with some horseradish. But first, I'll make a pretty much standard egg first, and then I'll go ahead and add some horseradish to the next one. Should I use spicy brown mustard? Or should I use Dijon mustard? Which one do you think? Tell you what, flip for it. Heads is spicy brown, tails is Dijon. Okay, ready? It's tails. Dijon wins. All right. And we need some mayonnaise. Now, actually, let's start with the liquid stuff. We're going to put some relish in first. I like relish in an egg because it gives it a little bit of sweetness. So, and let's put in a little bit of mustard that I'm going to put in. I'll put in about maybe for this amount of eggs, maybe a half a teaspoon. Not much. Just a little squirt. Okay, now let's put in some mayo. Let's start with about that much. Mix it through and see what we got. I'm going to put in a little white pepper. And I'm going to put in some...
Slap your mama!
This stuff's got a little heat in it. So let's mix all this stuff together. Looks pretty good. Looks Now, there's all kinds of things you can put in your eggs. You want to dice up some celery very fine. Or like I say, the bacon. Or if you want to use like, if you want to take some ham or even some Spam and then saute it till it's almost caramelized a little bit, that would be good too. Also, if I was going to be making like a lot of these, I would put this stuff into a plastic bag and cut the corner off so I could pipe the ingredients into the eggshells. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to do this. There's some. Probably going to have some left over here. I don't have too many eggs to fill up. So let's fill these oddballs like that. Now, I would love to add some horseradish, but I just realized that all my horseradish right now is frozen. The reason I do that is because horseradish will lose its pungency in the jar if you don't use it quick enough. And I found out that freezing it really retains that. I take an ice cube tray and I fill it with horseradish and then I crack them open and put them in a bag and put them away. So I actually have some in there, but I'm not going to bother with that. But what I do have is some of this onion blossom horseradish dip. Is that interesting or what? So I'm going to put some of this in here. And change the flavor a little bit. And then put that in these eggs here. I don't, these are mixed up. I don't know which ones are which. I don't care. I'm going to eat them all myself anyway. And as it turns out, I got some of this stuff left. And I ain't going to waste it. Truth is, I probably used a little too much mayonnaise. Oh well, you don't have to eat it. So, face down. Now, when you want to decorate your eggs, you could use some dill weed. Or you could use parsley. Or you could use paprika. It's all a matter of taste and what you prefer. You could even combination it. There you have it. A couple of variations on some deviled eggs. And be imaginative. You can put anything you want in there that would go good. What's your favorite flavors? Okay, let's try this one first. I just love deviled eggs, man. They're so good. They can be a lot more complicated. I mean, they're not that hard to make. It's just there's a lot of tedious work in it. All right. So there we go. Deviled eggs for the 50th show special. Anyway, let's go back to another commercial and we'll be right back with some more fun stuff.
Why should you subscribe to my channel? Well, because there's the John Show. There's Cooking with John. There's The Truth About Science. There's The Mime. There's Milo. There's The New Earth. There's Travelogues. And documentaries. And links to my website. There's comic strips. There's photography. There's my virtual art museum. I have several albums of original music. And my music videos. There's my stories. And my audio stories. There's even lots of art projects that have instructional videos so you can do them too. And so much more. Did I miss anything? Yes! I missed all kind of stuff! There's just too many things to even mention right now. I'm constantly doing something new. The only thing you can do is subscribe to my channel and look for the links and find me on the internet and keep up because I'm constantly coming up with something new. Hurry up before I have more stuff.
And now what you've all been waiting for, throwing stuff in the sink.
Ooh. Dang.
I'm done cutting.
Face down. Okay, so that was it. The 50th Cooking with John show. I hope you enjoyed it. I know I had fun. Please subscribe and share me with your friends and hit like and all that other fun stuff. Okay, everybody, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later. Bye!